Please see the link in the description to download a worksheet for this video. We suggest that viewers who are sensitive to the life sciences have an adult view this first to ensure it is suitable for that viewer. Weighing over 250,000 pounds and reaching over 90 feet long, this blue whale is heavier than all the students in pre-average sized U.S. schools combined. If a person was swimming with this whale, that person would be the length of the white line. On the other extreme, this butterfly is lighter than a paperclip and can be easily blown by a gentle breeze. Although they seem very different, all whales and butterflies are animals. In this video, we will introduce 7 groups of animals and a few of their subgroups. These 7 groups are insects, spiders, fish, amphibians, reptiles, birds, and mammals. Insects have no bones or any skeleton on their insides. Instead of an internal skeleton, they have a strong coat called an exoskeleton. It's a bit like what knights used to wear because it protects them like armor. They have 6 legs and a pair of antennae. Many have wings, and in addition to birds and bats, insects are among the only animals that can fly instead of just gliding. Some insects cannot fly, such as ants. Ants are famous for lifting things that are heavier than their own weight. Like insects, spiders have an exoskeleton instead of bones on their insides. Unlike insects, they have no antennae. Spiders have 8 legs, though some other animals that are not spiders also have 8 legs. Almost all spiders have 8 eyes. Although spiders are famous for their webs, only about half of them make webs. The next 5 groups of animals all have backbones, so we call them vertebrates. The word vertebrate means backbone. Fish are born in water, and with rare exception, spend their entire lives there. All fish have gills to help them breathe underwater. Biologists divide fish into 2 subgroups. One group is called bony fish since their skeletons are made of bones. That's most of the fish we see. The other group are called cartilaginous since their skeletons are made of cartilage. The common ones are sharks and stingrays. The very tip of our noses is made of cartilage, so by gently pinching your nose you can feel that it's softer than bones, like your elbow. In addition to gills, some fish can get oxygen in other ways, such as these mudskippers that absorb oxygen through their skin. Although all fish have gills, gills are not unique to fish. Octopuses have gills also, but they're not fish since they have no backbone. The amphibian group includes frogs, toads, and salamanders. They are born in the water and have gills for the first part of their lives. As they get older, some lose their gills and almost all grow lungs, so they can live on land. But they prefer to spend their lives near water to keep their skin moist. They can also absorb oxygen through their skin, which has no scales and it is usually thin. Most grow legs so they can walk or jump. There are 4 major subgroups of reptiles: alligators and crocodiles, turtles and tortoises, snakes, and lizards. Alligators are common in the southern parts of the U.S., whereas crocodiles are common in Africa. Alligators have wider snouts compared to crocodiles. Lizards include iguanas, geckos, and chameleons. Geckos are very common in the southern states and are famous for being able to climb anything due to the suction on their feet. Iguanas are found in South America. Chameleons are known for their ability to control each eye independently and for changing their color to match their surroundings. Tortoises can live longer than 100 years. Like birds and almost all fish, reptiles have skin that is covered in scales. Reptiles are cold-blooded, which means their body temperature will change depending on how hot or cold it is outside. And like birds, young reptiles are born inside eggs and then hatch. Reptiles have lungs, so those that live in water have to come up for air. There is huge variety among birds, but they have some things in common. Like reptiles and most fish, all birds have scales, which we often see best on their legs. And, like other animals with scales, a lot of birds live on or near the water. Like reptiles, young birds are born inside eggs and then hatch. Birds walk on their back 2 legs, and we call their forelimbs wings, even if they cannot fly, such as an ostrich. Some birds use their forelimbs as flippers, like penguins. All birds have feathers, and the only animals alive today that have feathers are birds. So, that is a unique feature. Unlike the prior groups, all birds are warm-blooded, which means they keep their body temperature around 100 degrees Fahrenheit, regardless of the outside temperature. Along with some insects and bats, birds are one of only 3 groups of animals that have members that can fly, rather than just glide. The last group we'll introduce are called mammals. These are very familiar to us because we and most of our pets are mammals. Mammals are the only animals that can grow hair, which we sometimes call fur. Wool is another form of hair. Some mammals have very little hair, such as this hippopotamus, which has whiskers. And some mammals lose their hair early in their lives, such as dolphins and whales. But all mammals have hair at some point in their lives. Mammals are the only group of animals that can make milk, which they feed their young. Like all birds can, mammals also keep their body temperature at a goal level, typically close to 100 degrees Fahrenheit. Since mammals are so common, many people learn the names for some of their subgroups, so we'll go over those. Equine is the subgroup of horses, zebras, and donkeys. Bovine is the subgroup of cows, bison, and buffalo. Porcine is the subgroup of pigs, hogs, and wild boars. Canine is the subgroup of dogs. That includes domestic dogs we keep as pets, but also foxes and wolves. Feline is the subgroup of cats. That includes domestic cats we keep as pets, but also tigers and lions. Rodents, which includes beavers, squirrels, mice, and rats. Cetaceans is the subgroup that includes whales and dolphins. In contrast to fish and reptiles, which swim by moving their tails from side to side, whales and dolphins move their tails up and down. And, like other mammals, whales and dolphins have lungs. That means they have to come up for air, which is in contrast to fish. In everyday use, sometimes we use words differently than how a biologist would. For example, jellyfish, shellfish, and starfish are not fish since none of them have backbones. Biologists often have to do blood tests to find the similarities among animals and put them in the right group. For example, even though a common name for this animal is a koala bear, biologists found they are not like other bears such as these, so biologists do not consider koala bears to be bears. Before we get to the final section, let's pause for a quiz question. Is this whale shark a fish? The big clue that this is a fish is that its tail moves sideways instead of up and down. Now that we've reviewed some groups of animals, we're ready for a working definition of an animal. An animal is a multi-cell living organism that eats plants or other animals and cannot use sunlight to make food directly. That's a big sentence, so let's break it into parts. The word cells refers to tiny units of life. Each of these box-like structures is a cell in a plant leaf. This animation shows nerve cells in animals. The prefix, multi, means many. So the first part of this sentence means animals are made of many small units. The second part says that animals eat plants or other animals. The final part refers to making food using sunlight. Plants, such as grass and trees, can make food for their growth using the energy in sunlight through a process called photosynthesis, which animals cannot do. Here are two final quiz questions. These one-cell organisms that are commonly found swimming in ponds can eat other organisms but can also make their own food using sunlight. Are these animals? No, they are made of one cell instead of many cells, and they can make their own food using the energy of sunlight. Whether an organism can move or not makes no difference as to whether it's considered an animal. These colorful, rock-like structures are types of corals. Corals cannot move. They get their food by filtering the water to find and eat tiny organisms. Are these animals? Yes, corals are made of many cells and eat other organisms for food, rather than making food using energy from the sun. Whether an organism can move or not makes no difference as to whether it's considered an animal. Here's a summary of this topic. Please pause the video if you wish to read this. If you're interested in practice tests that are similar to state exams, but with detailed, colorful explanations for each answer, then please see our apps in the App Store. Many of these are free and none expire or limit their function. Since we only make educational products for children, none of our apps have third-party advertising, in-app purchasing, or connect to the internet. Please subscribe if you'd like to be notified of future educational videos we make. Thanks for your attention.